different website, you might have seen this kind of UI design. Today, we are going to build the product card UI design with the help of HTML and CSS. Without further ado, let's start. Hello and namaste everyone, this is Jitsaru with Coding Design. Welcome to our channel. If you are new here, please be sure to hit that subscribe button. You can see I have already created the folder named images, and inside that folder there are different images with the PNG file format, and yeah, these are the images. Now let's create the index.html file. Inside the index.html file, if I type exclamation sign and hit that tab button, then you'll get this basic HTML code. Now let's give the title. For the title, I am giving product card, UI design, HTML and CSS. Inside the body tag, let's create the section with class name slider, and inside that section, let's create the div with class name card. Let's save the file, and now just below the title tag, let's link our CSS file. So I'm linking the style.css file, but I haven't created that file, so let's create that style.css file. I'm in VS Code, and if you have installed this extension called Live Server, then in index.html file, if you right click and hit that option called Open with Live Server, then it will open it in your default browser. Now let's go to the style.css file. Inside the root pseudo class, I'm declaring the different color variables. Okay, so I'm declaring the primary variable, and for the primary variable, I'm giving blue color, and for the secondary variable, let's give this green color. And for the busy variable, let's give this dark blue color. And for the universal selector, in order to prevent the browser's default margin and padding, I'm giving margin 0 and padding 0, and also box sizing to border box. Now let's style this section with class name slider. For the class slider, let's give the background color. I'm giving that VG variable, but in the browser now you won't see any changes. Okay, so first of all, let's style this div with class name card. For the class card, I want to give the width of 17 rem, and also for the height, I'm giving 23 rem. For the background color, let's give that primary color. So now if I save, that background color VG variable refers to this dark blue color, and that background color primary variable refers to this blue color. Okay, now for the class slider, I want to give the padding of 1 rem. Now you can see there is some space. Let's give display grid. Also, I am giving grid template columns. Let's give repeat 4, 1 fr. So now we are creating 4 columns with equal width. And also let's give font. For the font width, I'm giving normal. For the font size, I'm giving 1 rem. And also for the font family, let's give sans serif. Now let's duplicate this div with class name card, and if I save, now you can see there are 2 cards, but there is no proper spacing. Okay, so for that, for the class slider, let's give the grid gap. So I'm giving grid gap of 2 rem. Now you can see there is proper spacing between the cards. Similarly, now for the class card, let's give the border radius. For the border radius, I'm giving 1 rem. Now you can see there is rounded corners around the cards. And also I want to give the box shadow. For the x offset, I'm giving 0. For the y offset, I'm giving 0.2 rem. For the blur value, I'm giving 0.4 rem. And also for the color, I'm giving black color with alpha value 3. So now instead of that 0.4 rem blur value, let's give 0.6 rem. Okay. And also let's give the border. For the border width, I'm giving 0.1 rem. For the border style, solid. And for the border color, for now, I'm giving transparent. Now for the class card, when you hover, let's duplicate this border and let's take it to the hover section. And now instead of that transparent, let's give that secondary color variable. So now if I save, and in the browser now you can see when you hover the card you will get that green border line, but there is no any transition. So for that, for the class card, let's give the transition. For the transition duration I'm giving 0.5 second, and for the timing function let's give is in out. Okay, and also now when you hover the class card, let's give the transform, I'm giving a scale, and I want a scale to 1.05. now in the browser you can see when you hover your card you will get some kind of zooming effect with that green border line, and also there is some smooth transition. Okay, now for the class card I want to give the before pseudo element. So for the before pseudo element let's give the position of absolute, and for the class card let's give the position of relative. And also for the before pseudo element let's give content, I'm giving empty string. This content property is necessary, otherwise you won't be able to create that before pseudo element. And also I want to share the same CSS property for the after pseudo element. So for the class card I'm giving the after pseudo element, and this before and after pseudo element they are sharing the same CSS property. Okay, this CSS property. Now for the before pseudo element I want to give the width and height of 9rem. For the before and after pseudo element let's give the background color. For the background color I'm giving that secondary color. Also let's give the border radius of 50% so that it would make circle. Okay, now you can see in the browser that green circle. For the before pseudo element I only give the top and right -6%. But you can see that green circle is overflowing. Okay, so if I give for the class card overflow to hidden, then that problem will be solved. So in the browser now you can see that overflowed green circle that is hidden. Okay, now let's select this code and let's duplicate it. Instead of that before pseudo element let's give after pseudo element. And now instead of that top I want to give bottom, and for the right I want to give left. And also for the width and height I want to change it to 5rem. So in the browser now you can see I think it's looking good. Now when you hover the class card, for the before pseudo element I want to give the transform. For the transform let's give a scale, I want to scale to 1.8. And let's select this code and let's duplicate it. Now instead of that before pseudo element let's give after pseudo element, and instead of that 1.8 let's give 0. So now you can see when you hover the size of circle is increasing, but there's no any transition. Okay, so for the before and after pseudo element let's duplicate this transition code and let's take it to the before and after pseudo element. Okay, so now if I save, and in the browser now you can see when I hover look at that smooth transition. Okay, so this is what I want. Now let's remove this div with class name card, and now inside the div with class name card let's create the another div with class name card content, and inside that div I'm creating image element with class name card image, I mean card img. And for the source let's give images / HP laptop image, and also let's give the h1 heading with class name card title, and I'm copying and pasting the same image name. Okay, now you can see in the browser the image size is really huge. So now let's style this class card img. So in the styled css file for the class card img I want to give width of auto, and for the height 9.5rem. This is the exact size of the image that I wanted, but you can see there is some problem. When you hover that green circle is blocking the image. So in order to prevent that, now let's style that class card content. For the class card content I will give position absolute, and for the z-index let's give 200, and for the before and after pseudo elements let's give z-index of 100. Now you can see that green circle is taken to the backside. Okay, so this is what I want. And now let's style the div with class name card title. For the class card title let's give the font size of 1rem, And also for the car content, I'm going to give top 0, left 0. For the width, I'm giving 100%, and also for the height, I'm giving 100%. And also let's give display flex. For the flex direction, let's give column. And also for the justify content, I'm giving space around, okay. And if I save, and in the browser now you can see that image and the title. And also let's give align items to center so that it would bring horizontally center. And also for the class card, let's give color of that white color, okay. Now you can see that text color changed into white. Now inside the div with class name card content, I am creating another div with class name card body, and inside that div, let's create another div with class name card star. And inside that div, I am creating span tag with class name rating value, and inside that I am giving 4.5. Let's duplicate this code and let's change that 4.5 to HTML entity, okay. If I give ampersand has 9733, so with the help of this code you could get some kind of star icon. So let's change that class name to star. In the browser now you can see that star icon, okay. So now let's style that class star. So for the class star, let's give the font size of 1.4 rem. And also for the color, I want to give gold color. So in the browser now you can see that yellow star. And also just below the D with class name card star, I'm creating paragraph tag with class name card price. And I'm giving $650.99. And now let's style that paragraph tag with class name card price. For the class card price, let's give, I want to give font width of bolder. For the font size, I'm giving 1.5 rem. And for the font family, let's give sans serif. So now you can see that products price with bolder text, okay. Now let's style the div with class name card body. Now for the class card body, let's give width of 100%. And also let's give display flex. Justify content to space around. And also let's give align items to center. So now you can see that rating star and the price, they are taken to the same line. Now just below the div with class name card body, let's create another div with class name card footer. And inside that div, I'm creating button with class name btn, and also I'm giving another class name with btn success. And inside that I'm writing buy now, and let's duplicate this code and let's change it to add to cart, and also let's change that btn success to btn border. So in the browser now you can see there are two buttons. And now let's style that button with class name btn. So for the class btn, let's give padding. For the top and bottom, I'm giving 1 rem. For the left and right, I'm giving 2 rem. And also let's give background color. For the background color, for now let's give onset. So in the browser now you can see there is black border, so let's remove that border. So I'm writing border none. And also let's give outline none. And also I'm giving border radius. For the border radius, I'm giving 2 rem. And also let's give color of white color. For the cursor, let's give pointer, okay. So now when you take your mouse to that buttons, you'll get that pointing hand. And also for the class btn success, now for the class btn success, let's give the background color. For the background color, I'm giving that secondary color. So this is what I want, okay. And also for the class btn border, let's give the border, I want to give border width of 0.1 rem. For the border style, let's give solid. And also for the border color, let's give same secondary color. Now you can see in the browser two beautiful buttons. Now let's style the car img and car title. I'm sharing the same css property, so I'm writing comma and I'm giving transform translate y, and I want to give 4 rem. So in the browser now you can see that card image and the title, they are taken to the downside. And also let's give the transition. For the duration, I'm giving 0.5 second. And for the time function, I'm giving is in out. So this transition is necessary because when you hover the card, we're gonna change that transform property. So when you change any properties, there need the smooth transition. So for that, I'm writing transition. Okay. And so let's select this code and let's duplicate it. Let's take it to the downside. And now instead of that img, let's change it to body. And instead of that title, let's give footer. Now for the translate y, instead of that full rem, let's give it 8 rem. Now you can see button and also the price, they are hidden because for the class card we have given the overflow hidden, so the overflowed elements, they won't be visible. So now when you hover the class card, for the class card img and also for the class card title, card body, and also for the card footer, let's remove that comma and let's give transform translate y to 0. So we are taken to the original position. So in the browser now you can see when you hover the card, all the elements, they are taken to the original position. Now let's give some transition delay. Okay, so for the class card body, let's give transition delay of 0.2 second, and also let's give the transition delay for the class card footer. Let's duplicate this code and let's take it to the class card footer. And for the class card footer, let's give the transition delay to 0.3 second. And let's duplicate the same code, transition delay, and let's take it to the class card title. So if I save and the browser, now you can see this kind of cool effect. Now if I press F11 key, it will take you to the full screen. Now let's select this div with class name card and let's duplicate it for more 7 times, and let's change that source of image. Okay, instead of that HP laptop, now let's give the laptop 3.png image. Okay, in the browser now you can see, and also let's change that rating value to 4, and also let's change that price to 550. Now I'm changing all the images source, okay, and their title, their rating value, their price. Okay, now for the class car title, I'm gonna give text transform to capitalize so that each and every words, they would start with capital letter. Okay, now I'm changing all the images source, okay, and their title, their rating value, their price. So I'm speeding up the process. But if you love the, you know, light themes, something like, you can duplicate this VG variable and let's give light gray color. I'm giving F5, F5, and F5. And also let's duplicate this primary variable and let's change it to white color. And also let's comment it out this color. And also let's comment this color. Okay. And now in the browser you can see, oh, this is the light theme. So yeah, but I have noticed there that there is some problem with the transition delay. Okay. So for the class car title, for the transition delay, I'm giving 0.2 second, but there should be 0.1 second. Okay. So I want the 0.1 difference between the transition delay within these elements. Okay. In the browser now, you can see when I hover, well, now it's perfect. But I love the dark theme, so I will change it to dark theme. So let me know in the comment box, like, did you love the dark theme or the light theme? If you want to change it to your favorite color, then you can change it. Okay? You can just change the color variable's value. Then yeah, it's simple. So I'm changing back to the dark theme. So now everything is working perfectly. This is what I want. So that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you did learn something, smash that like button. If you have any kind of queries, let me know in the comment box. Share this video if you think someone needs it. And also, if you haven't already yet, hit that subscribe button and also the notification bell icon. Remember, there is always more to learn, so keep learning.